did get for the car. I treated myself. I bought myself a vintage parachute. I've been wanting one of those since I started working on this car. I have a vintage chute. You see the gold right there? That's a vintage chute. Pretty sure it's a Simpsons. From the 60s. But the cover that it was in, or the casing, got thrown out a long time ago. It had a tear in it. So, I know the chute's old because we had it on a car in the mid-70s and it was used then. So, this was just the case. You know, just as old. Late 60s, early 70s case. It's just the case itself. So, I actually want to mount it and hook it up to be used. I don't plan on ripping it at 120 miles an hour. But it'd be cool to rip it at like 30 miles an hour. Take a couple, a little video of it. So, I got to come up with somewhere to anchor it. So, wherever you anchor it has to be very strong. And the housing itself, a lot of people back then just hooked it to the sheet metal of the car. Which, I just got the gate done. That's where it would be. On a sedan, you can mount it off a bracket, but I still got to open up the tailgate on this thing. So, when I get it in my hand, I'll figure it out. But I'm thinking across the gate on this car. I don't have a picture of the back of this car. But across the gate on this car where it says Rambler American, popping that back off. And actually using the molding holes to hold it there. So I don't alter the gate in any way. And then actually tying in the two frame rails together behind the bumper. With an angle, plate, whatever it is, and have something come through right underneath the bumper. Where you actually hook the chute to. You know, when it deploys. So, like I said, I'm not looking for something that's going to stop me at 120 miles an hour, 30 miles an hour. But I'm not looking for something fake either. So, but I'll run the handle up inside the car. So, we'll see what happens when I get it. I just bought it yesterday, so I'm sure it's going to be a week. And I'm not going to start that project. I'm done with this project. But, yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. So, well, that's it, guys. See? It's actually a casing very similar to that. But I would run the cable underneath the car. And you know where the rear seat would be and you put your foot down? I'd run the cable through there and onto my tranny hump. The handle. And the actual casing here hooks to something solid. On a modern day race car, usually they triangulate it and it goes to both rails and it's a whole little to-do. But being I stored the factory tank in this car, that's not happening. If I didn't have the factory tank, I wouldn't care less. But, so that's what we're going to do. I think it'll look cool on the back. It's like a grayish silver. A little weathered looking, but no rips in it. So, that's it. Next, I guess we're going to be putting 200 pounds of Bondo on these fenders. Might keep me from doing another wheelie. But, yeah, like I said, to me, this is, I gotta know when enough is enough with the metal working. I'm just gonna cause more trouble or more problems that I'm gonna be able to handle. So, like I said, I will hammer and dolly it a little bit to get as many of the dimples and whatever out of it, little low spots. But by the most part, that low spot that's in the middle there is gonna have to stay. So. It's not like, as I just learned, it's not like pulling a low spot out of regular steel. You welded it there. And it is now welded into a V, if you want to word it like that. It's no longer welded flat. As it warped, I guess, you don't realize it. You're welding it in that shape now. And now you have hardened metal where the weld isn't all around it. So it's not like you can go in there with like one of those little, where you spot weld the rods on there and pull it out nicely. You're not dealing with that kind of metal anymore. This is hardened, hardened, hardened. And no matter how small the V is, it's shaped in a V. So, I'm gonna have to live with it. So, that's it.
Busted flat in Baton Rouge and heading for the trains. feeling nearly faded as my jeans. Bobby thumbed a diesel down just before it rained. Took us all away to New Orleans. I took my harpoon out of my dirty red bandana and was blowing sad while Bobby sang the blues. With them windshield wipers slapping time and Bobby clapping hands, we finally sang a velvet song that driver knew. Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing ain't worth nothing, but it's free. Feeling good was easy, Lord, when Bobby sang the blues. Feeling good was good enough for me. Good enough for me and Bobby McGee. From the coal mines of Kentucky to the California sun, Bobby shared the secrets of my soul.